What's up, YouTube? Joe Deasy here. I got a video of Eminem, and this has to do with him being cloned or maybe even murdered, and, you know, or the real Eminem, Slim Shady, being replaced with a clone. He talks with Stephen Colbert in this video, and the way Colbert talks to him, it's like he's one of his handlers or something, you know? Maybe not his handler, but it's like they're almost like trying to intimidate this Eminem. And they know that he's can't think straight or something, and they feed on that, and they just like almost harass him throughout this entire thing. You really feel bad for Eminem in this, and it's mind blowing. And then toward the end of the video, you'll notice that Colbert talks about maybe Eminem striking a deal with the devil or turning into a monster. So you'll see little references to Illuminati type stuff, you know, or selling your soul. You'll definitely see that. And, you know, like I said, you're just going to feel bad when you see this. I know I did. It's almost like I couldn't even watch it. So, and then you go back and read the comments of the video, and all these people think that that is truly Eminem, and they think it's just a big joke or something. It's not. I mean, you can totally tell. This is supposed to be a rapper who can't keep his mouth shut about anything that's going on, you know? And in this, he can't find the words to say anything. He can't defend himself. He's very timid, very shy. And it's just like not how somebody would act if they've been in the public spotlight for so long. You'd think that they'd be able to, you know, carry on a conversation with somebody. Now, I'll give him that. Colbert is kind of pouncing on him in this, but Eminem, the real Eminem, would have knocked him the fuck out, okay? And so here's some of the comments that they said, and then we'll get to the video. How did Eminem keep a straight face? I would have died laughing. Let's see. I don't know how either of them can keep a straight face. Okay, so we'll go down here. We'll just read a couple more. I'm just going to randomly scroll, and we'll see what we can find. This is painful to watch. I agree. They made this so awkward, it was hard to watch. That's what's great about it. They're acting awkward so well, you actually believe neither of them even know each other. Now, that's fucking funny. You know, when people are fooled that well. See, the amount of people that don't understand scripted interviews is staggering. Okie dokie. So, without further ado, here is the Stephen Colbert Eminem interview.
In Monroe only. My next guest is a local Michigander who is making a name for himself in the competitive world of music. Please welcome Marshall Mathers. Marshall, thanks so much for being here today.
Thanks for having me.
Pleasure. Now, are you from the Monroe area?
I am not. I am from the Michigan area.
But you are a native
from
Michigander.
Detroit. Yeah,
you're from Detroit. Oh, Detroit. Okay. How'd you get down here today? Did you take I-75?
Yep.
Traffic's pretty tough right now. There's a lot of construction.
Yeah.
Plus with all the flooding.
Right.
Yeah. You know the River Raisin is crested.
I did not.
Didn't
know
that.
No. Well,
the important thing is just don't drink any sewage. All right. Just do for the next 24 hours. Okay. Fight it. So, from Detroit, who are some of your big musical influences? I imagine Motown, Ted Nugent, obviously, Seger?
Bob Seger's great, yeah.
He's great. Okay, let's see how much of a Michigan native you are. I'll name some Bob Seger songs and you see whether you can sing any part of them, okay? Against the Wind.
Against the Wind. Running Against the Wind.
That's pretty good. Well, I gave that one away because it's in the title. Okay, how about Like a Rock?
I forget the melody.
Like a rock! There is actually no melody. He just screams like a rock for 3 minutes, and then they roll trucks by. I think the video was just, is it Chevy trucks? Is it Chevy? Just all Chevy trucks. Night Moves.
I know the song, I forget the melody.
Little too tall, could use a few pounds.
Give me the hook. Where's it?
Night Moves. Night Moves. Yeah.
Okay.
Fire Lake.
Who wants
wants to go to Fire Lake? Strut? Oh, I love to watch a strut! Jump in anytime here. Kathmandu!
That was good.
Thank
that
you.
Was good.
You
yeah.
claim you're from Michigan. You I don't know any of these
I know
songs.
Kathmandu. There's a couple of
Rock
them.
Rock and roll never forgets anything. Rock and roll never forgets. Okay. Roll me away, won't you roll me away? Turn the page. Someday, lady, you'll accompany me. Are these ringing any bells?
Yes, they are. You're going really fast, though. Like, I can't.
Okay.
Yeah.
I thought you were a rapper. Don't rappers talk fast? Are you one of those slow-talking rappers or one of the fast-talking rappers?
Mm-hmm. Can be both, I guess.
Old-time rock and roll. I'll throw you a softball here. Old-time rock and roll.
I like that old-time rock and roll.
Yeah, Tom Cruise in the underwear. That's exactly right. All right. So what kind of, let's talk about your career, enough Bob Seger. What kind of rap do you do? Are you like sort of sing-songy rap like Bone Thugs and Harmony, or are you more like street like Will Smith?
I like Bone Thugs and I like Will Smith.
Okay. Which are you closer to?
Middle.
The middle? Okay.
Probably.
Are you political? Because a lot of rap is very political and some of it is just like good booty rhymes. Are you more political or are you more booty rhymes?
In the middle?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I kind of
right in the middle of the booty?
Right in the crack, probably.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's a steamy place.
Yeah.
To have your career.
Right.
All right.
Steamy place to be.
Mm-hmm. I noticed on a lot of rap songs, and you know more than I do about this because you're in the rap world. A lot of times it'll say feat, you know, like they'll say like someone's song, whoever, Rihanna, feat. Pitbull or something like that. It often says Feet Pitbull. I think Pitbull's my first name might actually be Feet. Have you ever been Feet Marshall Mathers? Have you ever feeted?
I have feeted.
Mm-hmm. What does
yeah.
it mean when you're feeding? When it says feet, what does that
featuring?
Mean? Featuring. Oh, featuring. Okay, so it's just somebody's you're helping. Mm-hmm. Can we see his face? He's got a hoodie on. Can we see his face? Is lighting okay with that? Are we okay with that? Okay. Have you thought about taking the hoodie down? Because you've got, you know, just as an entertainer, and I'm in the entertainment industry, you've got such a cute face. Why hide it underneath
thanks.
The hoodie? That's your little moneymaker.
Yeah,
why hide?
Why?
Nah, you should probably put the hoodie back.
Yeah, probably. Okay.
Yeah, my mistake. You know your business. You know business better than I do. Can we get serious for a second?
Yeah, mm-hmm. sure.
Do you worry about the kids listening to rap? Because some of it gets pretty rough with you know, the F this and the SH bomb that.
Oh, I don't do any of that.
You don't do it?
No.
You keep it clean?
Keep it clean.
Give a message to the rappers out there who are dropping that kind of language and say, tell them, like, you don't have to do it.
You don't have to do it. Watch your mouths.
Okay. Thank you. That is refreshing. That is refreshing. All right. So where do you hope this goes? Is this a career or more of a hobby? Is this sort of like a thing to do with your buddies on the weekends?
It's both.
That's good.
It's career and a hobby.
Okay, it's a pretty tough business though, you know? Do you have a fallback position? Is there something else you know how to do, like carpentry or HVAC? Everybody needs HVAC. We're always gonna need HVAC.
Carpentry sounds mm-hmm. like it could be mm-hmm. good.
Mm-hmm. Do you have what I'm saying is that, how old are you?
42.
If you ever want to have a family and, you know, care for them, while it's fun, and obviously everybody should have something fun they do when they have time, you should really have something. And this is nothing about your talent. This is an older man talking to a younger man about what you're going to need to have in place 10 years from now. You need to think 10 years down the line, am I going to have a retirement account? You just have to make plans for when the dream dies. And, you know, dreams die. You know, it happens. And fun is fun.
I'm so confused right now. I'm trying to figure out if you're serious or if...
I'm very serious. If you don't have a retirement account by the time you're 50, you're dead in the water. There's nothing to be done at that point. You're a greeter at Walmart at that point.
Yeah, no,
you're
I
I am Marshall. Children's toys are over that way.
Right.
You're dead.
Right.
You're going, why don't I listen to him?
No,
I understand this is probably important to you on a certain level, and you probably told your friends, I'm going to make it. I'm going to be the guy who doesn't give up. You told your parents, is this good enough for you, old man? But there's a certain point you have to be humble and say, maybe it doesn't happen for
you. Right.
Maybe it doesn't happen for you, Marshall.
You really don't know. I mean, I put out quite a few albums.
Well, I'm sure that feels good.
It does.
It does. Well, good. Doesn't pay the rent. Like what? What would I know?
I mean, it sort of does. Pay the rent.
It pays the rent?
Yeah.
Good. Mm-hmm. What have you done? I mean, I'd like to apologize. If you're a bigger deal than I know about, here's the thing. This is all my research people. I want to know who you are. I just don't know who you are.
That's fine.
Okay, good. You seem pretty mad.
I'm not mad at all.
Not mad at all. Okay. Well, you were getting pretty angry a second ago.
I think I just look angry.
Yeah. Well, that's good. That works for rap.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you've done some stuff. You've got an album. You've featured on somebody. You featured with people.
I featured on somebody.
You featured on somebody.
I featured on quite a few somebodies.
Okay, good. So now you're getting angry again.
No, not at all. I'm just trying to figure out why I'm here.
Somebody's got a project to push on Only in Monroe, and I will do my best to do it now since you evidently only want to do that. All right, so you've got a movie, and it's called Southpaw. And I'll do the introductions, thank you. Southpaw, and it stars Jake Gyllenhaal.
Jake Gyllenhaal.
Fine. It's Jake Gyllenhaal with two A's. And you produced it, and you did the soundtrack for it, and I believe we have a clip. Millward? Every ounce of my blood, every breath in my lungs, won't stop until I'm free, not alone. However long it takes, I'll go to whatever lengths, it's gonna make me a monster though. I'm sorry, I apologize. There's also a cat doctor who does a show on the cable access show here, and I think that was the cat doctor's footage. It's pretty good though. Is that anything like that in the movie?
I mean, that was the song.
Do we have the right tape? It should say, there's a VHS tape up there that says the right clip or Gyllenhaal or something on the side. Can we play that?
I am phenomenal!
How'd you like to fight for that title?
You think that you can beat Magic?
Not without you.
I'm gonna fight again. I'm gonna get my kid back.
What chance is there that Hope could win? The cause is stacked against Hope.
They say Billy Hope can't make it. Billy Hope is over. This is your time. This is your moment.
You can control your destiny.
Well, that's great. Now, you wrote all that music?
Yeah. I mean, that song.
Yeah, that's a beautiful song.
Thanks.
It worries me a little bit, though. Can I talk about... Can I spit some of your lyrics back at you? Am I using the term correctly? Spit.
Yeah.
Okay, good. All right. The song is called Phenomenal, and it goes a little bit like this. Okay. By the way, Jake is jacked in that. Is he always like that, or did he get jacked for that movie? He's super jacked.
Yeah. I'm not sure. You have to ask him.
He's really fit. That's not what he's normally like. You have to know that.
You're
the producer of the movie. You have to know that he didn't look like that beforehand, right, when you hired him.
They put his head on my body.
Really?
For that shot.
You work out?
Yeah.
Come on, flex on, flex off. Give me a little.
Oh, I mean, you really can't. It's really nothing.
That is nothing. That is, come on, man. Do you want to go? Are you about to go?
Flex?
Were we about to go?
Not unless you wanted to, I mean.
I don't want to, but I will not back down. If you were about to go, I'm not backing down. You're in my house.
If you were about
to come into my house, You come into my house and you flex up on me and you expect me to back down? You are sadly mistaken. Hoodie? Yeah.
I'm not sure what to do here.
No. No, you don't.
It's quite frightening.
I would keep it that way.
It's quite frightening.
All right, you stay confused.
I am really confused right now.
All right, let's talk about your lyrics. I'm sorry. I was fronting. I want to apologize.
That you were.
I was fronting.
That you were.
These are the lyrics. You say, I am phenomenal, however long it takes. I'll go to whatever lengths. It's going to make me a monster, though. The question is here, is that a message you're sending to the kids, which is, if you reach for your dreams, okay, you can be the best, but it's going to turn you into some sort of unrecognizable monster that you'll regret. Is that the message?
Not necessarily, but...
That's what the lyrics say.
I mean, that's, I guess maybe that's your interpretation of them.
It says, "It's I am phenomenal, however long it takes, I'll go to whatever length, it's going to make me a monster, though.
I'm just saying, whatever.
Do you have to be a monster to be phenomenal?
I mean, you don't have to be, but what I'm saying is, if I go to these lengths and these extremes and however, if I keep trying, it's going to turn, my perseverance is going to turn me into something other than human, an animal.
Has that happened to you, Marshall?
Maybe metaphorically speaking.
Well, yeah. I can understand that.
Yeah.
And I ask for personal reasons because I'm going to start a new project in the fall. And I'd like to be phenomenal, but I don't want to turn into a monster. Is it possible? I guess what I'm asking is it possible to be phenomenal and not lose your humanity?
I mean, you have to find a balance.
What is the balance? How do you find the balance? Do you do hot yoga?
No, I meditate a lot.
Do you really meditate?
Yeah.
I know, obviously, you can teach me.
I'm meditating right now.
Really?
Yeah, because this is really weird.
Now, I understand that Southpaw comes out July 24th. We'll be playing only in Monroe or all across Michigan?
It should be playing all across Michigan.
Okay, good.
And hopefully beyond.
Okay, well, congratulations. That is phenomenal. Anything you want to say to the local people in Monroe?
What up, Monroe?
Well, Marshall Mathers, thank you so much for joining me.
Am I performing next, or?
That would be great, but we are kind of tight on time, okay? Come back in August, because I think I'm hosting again then, and you'll be phenomenal. Marshall Mathers, we'll be right back.
For over 8 generations, any time of the year, folks have been coming to downtown Monroe to shop, eat, be entertained, and connect with friends, old and new. Experience the pleasures of local shopping where the homegrown business owners know you by name, where value isn't just about price, but knowledge, time, and care. Take a break, slow down, have coffee, have dinner, or take in a show. We're a real downtown. We are authentic. Authentic Downtown Monroe. Rediscover us.
First record was in 99.
Oh,
with
yeah.
Dr. Dre.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, you did that thing with Elton John at the Grammys.
Yes.
Oh, shit. Yeah, I apologize. Yeah, I know who you are. I know who you are.
Okay.
You're the dude who did the thing with Elton John at the Grammys.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wonder yeah, I did.
Why.
Right. So you know it.
Yeah.
Can I perform now?
No, we don't have time. Well, that's all the time we have for Only in Monroe. But before we go, let's take a peek at Monroe's community calendar. Marshall, you want to help me out with this?
Well, it says on the teleprompter that I'm supposed to say I'd love to, Stephen.
That's great. Thanks. On July 1st, an infant CPR safety and care class will be offered from 10 a.m. to noon. So if you're an infant interested in CPR or just a fan of unobstructed breathing, head on down to the Monroe County Health Department, 2353 South Custer Road. Marshall?
And remember to check out the River Raisin Independence Festival and fireworks on July 3rd. You can celebrate America's independence from England and Monroe's independence from celebrating the 4th on the 4th. It's your last chance to see fireworks in Monroe until New Year's Eve on December 30th.
Tuesday, July 7th, is the monthly meeting of the Monroe Coin Club. Stop by if you're a numismatist, or if Tuesday is laundry day and you just need to break a single.
Wednesday, July 8th, Kinetic Chiropractic at 2059 North Monroe Street will offer a free class for handling stress. No late admission. Get it together for once in your life and show up on time.
On July 15th, stop by City Hall for Beginning Birding Basics. Reminder for birders, vests with under 8 pockets will not be admitted.
July 22nd is the Monroe Mayor's Traffic Committee. All traffic officials are required to be at the meeting, so if you're on the road between 5 and 7 p.m., floor it.
Well, that's community calendar for July. What month comes next? Find out next time, only on...
Only in Monroe.
Before we go, I'd like to thank everyone at Impact. Thank you all so much. We couldn't have done it without you. And if you're in Monroe, make sure you stop by Larson's Bar and Grill and ask for Alex. You won't regret it. I also want to thank my guest, Marshall Mathers. Thank you, Marshall. But mostly, Michelle Bauman and Kehlani Ray Rothko Wilson. Goodbye, ladies.